In this video, we will demonstrate how to use IRBCAM to create the sign shown in this photo using an industrial robot and a machining spindle. In this particular example, we have a machined using a ball nose, a milling tool, and a small spindle, and we have machined in wood. And industrial robots are suitable for machining in soft materials like wood, plastics, composites, but also soft materials like aluminium. The first step in the process is to calibrate the tool. In this picture we see a coordinate frame where the red axis is the tool x-axis, the green axis is the tool y-axis, and the blue is the tool z-axis. So when calibrating the tool, basically we want to find the distance from the mounting flange of the robot to the tip of the tool. And we also want to describe the orientation. You see here, there is usually the z-axis of the tool is straight out of the flange, and you see here there's a rotation of 90 degrees about the green axis, so the tool y-axis. The controller usually has a method for a tool calibration which will help you. So in these four pictures we see that we have placed a sharp calibration tool on top of the machining table. And here we use the built-in four-point method in the controller to position the ball nose milling tool as close as possible to that sharp tip with four different orientations. So in the first picture on the top left, the spindle is sort of more or less vertical. In the second picture, top right, we have rotated the spindle towards the left with quite a large angle. The third picture, bottom left, we have rotated the other way towards the right. And the fourth picture, we have a rotation backwards towards the robot. In order to get a good calibration, it's important to use a large variety of angles here. They should not all have the same orientation, then the calibration will fail. It should also be said that it's actually enough with 3 points. So having a 4-point method, we have an extra measurement. And that extra measurement can be used by the controller to give an accuracy of your calibration. So typically you should aim for an accuracy result of 0.3 millimeters or better. And if you find that your calibration is worse than that, so you're not satisfied with the accuracy, you can still use the result from the first iteration to define your tool. Then it will be easier to orient it around that calibration, that sharp calibration tool. So maybe you have to iterate like 3 to 4 times until you get the accuracy that you are satisfied with. In this case, the results are shown on the right here. The numbers here are in millimeters. So x equals 168.77 millimeters. That's the distance from the mounting flange of the robot to the tip of the ball nose tool in the x direction. The quaternion here, Q1 to Q4, represents that 90 degree rotation about the y-axis. The second step in the calibration is to define the user frame. Again, we see this coordinate system in the station here, and the red axis is the user frame x-axis, the green is the user frame y-axis, and the blue is the user frame z-axis. When doing this calibration, we want to find the distance from the base of the robot to the origin of this user frame. That's the X, Y, and Z positions of the user frame. In addition, there can be an orientation change from the base frame to the user frame, which will be defined by another quaternion. Here we use a built-in 3-point method in the controller, So the bottom left picture shows position x1, which is the origin of the user frame. And here we put that at the corner of the machining table. The picture in the middle, position x2, is along the x-axis. And here it's important to move the robot a long distance to get a good accuracy result. If you just make a short move between x1 and x2, then a small error in the y direction will influence your x-axis vector much more than if you have a long move. Finally, the third photo here is along the y-axis. This is position y1. And you see, sometimes it's not possible to make a long move because the robot may, for example, go out of reach, or the table is shorter in that dimension. So the results here are x equals 899.54 millimeters. That's the distance from the base of the robot to the corner of the table in the x direction. And the quaternion here is Q1 to Q4. It shows that we also have a rotation of the axis compared to the base frame. The third step in the calibration is to define the object frame. The object frame is relative to the user frame. So here you see we have placed an object on the machining table, and we place the origin at position x1 as shown in the bottom left photo. Position x2 is in the middle, and here use a long distance, so we've used the entire length of the object to define the x-axis. And the third photo is position y1, which defines the y-axis. And note here, because of the short distance of the object in that direction, it's not possible to make a longer move to define that axis. The results here are 1125.66 millimeters in the x direction. That's the distance from the corner of the table to the origin of the object in the x direction. We see here the quaternion Q1 to Q4. This is close to 0, 0 and minus 1 at Q4, which means that we have rotated the object frame approximately 180 degrees relative to the user frame.